the primer. Want to say you have oily skin?
I do too.
So. You do? What do you use?
People have been sleeping on e.l.f. Cause like,
I sleep on e.l.f. So far, Kat Von D has been the one. Fenty's trash for oily skin.
Oh, okay. I thought you
meant
like...
No. Like, Fenty's amazing.
Okay.
Fenty's amazing. But for oily skin, I was highly disappointed.
I agree. The thing with Fenty is that... people think this is a conspiracy, but I really feel like that she only made her foundation to go with her primer. Like, I don't think that she...
thought about it going with something else. And that's right. Smart as far as her business.
Right. But... I mean,
not everyone's gonna buy both. But the thing is, I bought both.
You did?
And I bought both. And every time I wear it, I am oily for days. I have it with me.
Interesting.
If someone is my shade, I would sell it to them because it's very full. Mm-hmm. I bought it last spring break when I was going to Miami. And I don't know what it was, but it worked the week that I was in Miami. As soon as I come back to Texas,
oh, because it's not as humid.
Maybe. I don't know.
But it's still like this album.
But, yeah, I was just confused because it just completely stopped working. And I would get so oily. Every time I wear it, people would be like, Lizzie, you have some oil. And I'm like, I know.
Like your job.
Oh my gosh, I love it.
I love it.
Everything's good so far. The actual job, I'm a digital sales specialist, so like we learn something about structure. Software.
How are you?
So I'm really excited about the future roles and stuff about it.
Hello.
Sorry.
You're getting things done.
I don't know if I can overlap.
Be my best friend,
please.
You're so cute.
But no, I love it. Everything's good. Like, coworkers, work-life balance. I just need opportunities. I never thought this was okay, so whenever we worked together at G-Force, I was still pre-med. So I always thought, you know, after college, I'm going to go to med school and all that stuff. So I think the switch has been really nice to just see that there's so much outside of what I originally thought.
Right.
And like, as long as you do your due diligence, like God will have a plan.
Right.
And so like being able to really experience that, like doing a complete 180 from, you know, pre-med, like I was literally prepping for that to now like working with a really nice company that allows us to travel and stuff. Like we're traveling for work, but they encourage side trips. Like they want us to like enjoy. And so I think it's great. Oh my gosh! Hey.
Hi.
I can hear you now.
Hi.
How was church?
Oh, it was good. It was good.
Good. Yay! Oh, I'm so happy to see you.
Yes, I'm happy to be here.
Doing our international.
I see you've met Roman.
Yes, we are best friends now.
Yay!
He is so cute.
Chloe, it's just like,
so sweet.
Whatever you have your heart and your mindset to, do your part, like do your due diligence, do your work, and then continue to ask questions. Like, I feel like I wouldn't have any of those opportunities if I didn't reach out and ask people. A lot of people have this pride issue that they don't want to like let someone know their struggle.
Right.
But how else can someone help you if they don't know? Yeah, exactly. So. People can say all day, like, you know, I wish you the best, but you'll know if they go out of their way to, you know, connect you with someone that can actually get you to where you want to be ultimately. That's when you're like, wow, you really care about, like, you know, my life and like, my decision. So, like, reaching out to me when I was in my senior year doing the switch was really helpful. They gave me all kinds of advice. And I took tips from everything. Like, I still remember my first interview. It was an insurance company.
Just waiting on the
New York Life.
Yeah, isn't that fun?
Yeah. $1 million.
I literally went like, to some random Twitter fan. I was the youngest person that I've ever
been
told.
Right.
Please, so I go and I'm just like, I'm looking for a job. And they're like, oh,
I'm
like, you're in
everything.
College.
I just got
like,
a really
why
good
are you
job
here?
Have
you, but they liked that. And so,
company that produces furniture.
Of course, insurance is not for her. My passion was, but the opportunity to have the interview with him. He told me something that was really helpful, and I feel like I've taken bits and pieces from each person and like kept
right
it.
Now,
so,
which I love,
with that being
my
first
like
interview,
not
something
not
he said,
career
like,
wise,
we were talking,
yeah,
and he was like, well, like, you know, he's very mature for your age. You know, like, typically, I don't meet tons of people that think what they do. So he asked me, like, okay, I've got like a trivia question for you. There's no right or wrong answer, but try to give your best answer. What would you consider to be the biggest nation? And I was like, oh shit, like I didn't expect this to be random. Like, you're an insurance company. So I'm over here thinking like China, you know, US, and like trying to think of what they're known for. Thinking he's trying to like, you know, ask me about like global
company,
stuff, and,
yeah,
like the company, right? So I give him this answer like, you know, I would personally say that China is the biggest nation because of the mass production and, you know, how efficient they are. And, you know, they have had to, like, kill people off and, like, kill the daughters and keep the sons in order to reduce their population size. So I would consider them in all aspects, as far as the consumer world, industries, and population, to be the biggest nation. I'm over here trying to give them this, like, whole response. He said, that's interesting. But that's not the answer. And I was like, oh. And so he draws on this piece of paper, and he shows it to me, and he said, the biggest nation is your imagination.
Ooh.
And I was like, wow. Like, I didn't expect that one from an insurance company interview, especially in, like, round one, and the fact that, like, everyone in that office was, like, you know, older. So I didn't know if they were, like, creative or if they were just trying to think, you know, factual. Let's get people to buy insurance, buy insurance, buy insurance.
Yeah.
So I was just like, wow. He was just telling me, like, you know, always remember that. Moving forward, like, where even if you choose this company or if you choose another one, that the biggest nation is your imagination. Like, what you can dream of for your life, that can happen. And I was like, wow. So that's something that really stuck with me that I didn't expect, you know, I would get that type of advice. But it's like, you never know what type of advice you'll get from people that are not like you. Because that's where you get, like, the holistic perspective. So, yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, I don't know. I swore up and down that I was about to, like, after college, do, like, social work,
yeah,
type of stuff. And that's something that I am passionate about.
Yeah.
But, man, it's very spiritually draining.
Yeah.
Especially, like, I want to work with kids.
Yeah.
And it's just,
it's gonna be hard to see.
That's
them like
a whole
that.
Lot. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And just from working with, I used to work for the city, and doing like after school work, and a lot of those kids, you know, came from really tough like backgrounds, and so just doing that was a lot for me. And so yeah, I don't know. Like, makeup is always something that I've like done. So I'm just like, I mean, why not take this chance? And like, just off of one shoot, like, I want to say like almost a month ago or so, I've been like doing stuff every weekend. Like, I've had people asking me every weekend. And
that's
like,
really good.
Yes. It's something I actually enjoy doing. Like, I enjoy doing the other stuff, and eventually, you know, I want to slowly do like activism and like really pushing for kids who have the disadvantage.
Yes.
Because kids are our future and we need them.
Yes.
So
for sure.
I still want to do that, but you know, I want it to be more like activism and like a lot of putting my own money into it.
Yes.
And I can't do that right now.
No, I feel you.
So
I think everything you want to do is beautiful. And it could definitely happen for you.
Yeah.
You just have to figure out what's gonna make you stand out in this industry. Because every industry is going to be highly saturated. The makeup right now is highly saturated.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the difference in a lot of makeup artists or like creative work is that
a lot of people initially do it as a hobby, and not many people do it as a business. So if you want to do it as a hobby, then you're thinking now, and you probably won't take it to the extent of like really prepping the vision of where you go. But if you do it thinking like, okay, this is of course my passion, but I want to turn this into a business, that's what's going to differentiate you. And your clients will see that, and people will see it in your work. If someone else has a vision but they don't know how to bring it to life, then I would be the one to help them with that.
That's awesome.
And so it's kind of like connecting all the dots. So figure out how you can connect all your dots, and then just like do it.
Right.
And you'll be like nervous and all that stuff, because I definitely was and still am. Because it's like, dang, is this really happening? Like,
yeah.
Putting yourself out there and stuff like that. But you'll see the return, and you'll be like, wow.
Right. I feel like you kind of know you're doing something you need to be doing when you're uncomfortable and when you're nervous.
Yes.
Because you're not going to see a result if you're not uncomfortable.
Exactly.
Change doesn't come with being staying in a place.
Exactly.
Which is something I'm still trying to...
Yeah, ooh. No, you have to be uncomfortable to really grow. That's why I was like, okay, this move will have to be very uncomfortable, because I don't know anything
about Chicago.
But, there's nothing to lose and everything to gain.
Right.
I already have Dallas as the base. Might as well build the base there, you know? So.
You never know where you're gonna come across.
Exactly. This one girl has been such a help, like, with the whole prep for me moving to Chicago. She's out there, and she was like, yeah, whenever you come, I want you to meet one of my friends. She's like a hairstylist, whatever, and she works with Tokyo Styles. I said, wait.
Tokyo? Yeah.
So wait, you lying, bro? And she's like, yeah, like there's people that are like mad connected out here.
That's awesome.
So I was like, wow. That's the type of stuff that you staying in Dallas, you may or may not get. Like, there's people, but
it's a nice start.
It's a nice start.
Yeah.
And some people use it as the end goal, which is still good too, because I definitely want to come back. And the taxes are amazing here. The what you can get bang for your buck, the space, square footage, all of that.
Definitely.
Great area. Great area. But as far as us being like youthful, there's so much you can learn in other areas. Then bring it back, like you said. Sorry, I wear contacts.
No, you're fine. Sorry, I'm trying not to.
I'm like.
I'm trying to make sure
you're
all
good. Oh, Katie, there's food in the back if you're hungry.
Cool.
Yeah, go help yourself. Eat it all if you need. Take as much as you want.
Yeah. I was doing really good doing it like every 6 weeks, and then I stopped.
Yeah.
6 weeks? So there was 10 weeks.
Yeah.
I think
I need to order you some more of this.
This is so exciting. This might be perfect, even if, you know, life still goes on.
Right. And there's always, doing this every year.
Doing it every year, it's going to be, yeah. And the hope is that it gains traction. Because last year, everyone was like, oh my gosh, you should enter it into like an art contest. Because there's a lot of like art contests that are hosted by like art museums, like local ones, but I didn't have the time. So this year I'll definitely try. And then I found more information on International Women's Day, and they even have a contest.
Oh.
So I can enter it in there. And so I don't know where this is ultimately going to go, but it can go pretty far. So I'm just excited. And that's why I want to do it with like the same consistent people. Because then you'll eventually see growth, you
right?
Know? Like, not just with the vision, but even, like, with the models, like, with everyone. Katie, how's church?
Good. Good.
What was the message? I missed service today.
So, we did a message over how you rely on your gifts.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes that doesn't feel like a bad thing. You feel like, it's my gift. Like, I'm good at this. It's God-given. Like, why is it bad for me to rely on my gift? But then you're not relying on the Lord. You're relying on the gift, not the gift giver.
Oh, okay, yes.
You're buying identity in the gift instead of the gift giver.
Yeah.
So he just like really drilled that home through Ephesians of like, we all have different gifts. We all like, the Lord is infinitely creative.
Yeah.
So we have all kinds of gifts to give.
Yeah.
But you just have to be refreshing with the gift giver so that those gifts are getting better and better.
Okay.
Instead of trying like to improve them with your flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can't. And you might manipulate it, and you might make it, you know, better by worldly standards. But if you're coming back to the gift giver and saying, what do you want me to do with this gift? How do you want me to improve?
Yeah.
It's just a good and wholesome, like, refreshing. So we just talked about gifts.
I like it.
Yeah, it was really good today. I was really happy.
No, that's a good message. Yeah. Especially what we were just talking about.
Yeah, I was like, that's like really
everything.
Yeah.
No, that's a good reminder as well. Like, mm-hmm. we all have a gift.
Yeah.
No, that's really good. This is really exciting.
Yeah.
Can I have more pink on my cheeks?
Yeah.
Okay. This is so cool.
So I think then, I came in after you told everyone, what is the next step for you? Where are you headed?
Oh,
Chicago?
Yes,
heard Chicago.
Yes. Ooh. So I'm moving to Chicago for an 18-month rotation for work.
Incredible.
And I'm really excited. Start date's in April, so it's very abrupt.
Yeah.
And I'll be done August of 2020. So
wow.
The good thing is it's not gonna be like a permanent, I have
yes.
to live there forever.
Yes, which really helps perspective.
Exactly. I just wanna really grow and evolve
yes.
in an area where I've never been.
Yes.
Because I feel like that's where you can really find yourself.
Yes.
So like I know who I am and what I want, of course, so I have my vision together, but I feel like I can grow so much more, especially being in my 20s, not having any kids or attachments and stuff.
Oh, it's so nice.
So
it's
I'll be
gift.
There.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Huge gift. Huge.
I'm really excited because it works well with like actual work, like my full-time corporate job, then with my image consulting business that I have on the side,
yeah.
and like YouTube and like creative work.
Oh yeah.
Chicago's just like
it's perfect.
Exactly.
Olivia Reed lives there. She's a YouTuber blogger.
Yeah.
It's just
you have to send me her stuff.
Yes. Like there's never a shortage of content of things
exactly.
going on. Like just never. Yeah, I love Chicago. It's beautiful.
Have you been?
I've been twice. I've been both in summer and winter, so I've seen like its best and its worst.
Yeah.
But it's stunning. I really love
Yay.
Chicago a lot. It's amazing.
Now y'all have a reason to come visit.
I know.
My friend
Jessie
is from Chicago.
Oh really?
Yeah, she just moved here.
Oh, she just moved here from Chicago?
Yeah.
Ooh, I can definitely talk with her because
yes.
when I tell y'all I've never been to Chicago. But it was like God was tugging at my heart.
Mm-hmm.
Our manager literally told us so like abruptly. So we travel a lot for work and we've been out of the Dallas office for like 2 weeks straight. So she's giving us all this information on Monday of this week. And she's like, guys, there's an opening, great opportunity in Chicago. Who's interested? Yeah, let's take it. Like, why not?
I love that.
And she was like, okay, like, I'm putting y'all down. Going back out. And
yeah,
we
she's like looking at you like,
we're like, wait, hold on.
I know.
What you mean?
Yeah, like, hold on, what do you mean? Like, you just told us today.
Yeah,
and then on Wednesday, she confirmed and was like, yeah, I talked to the managers and everything. Like, y'all are good to go. And we were like,
yeah, I did the
gosh,
same
like,
thing. Me and like a really good friend of mine, we both moved to LA for 4 months.
Really?
And like,
how was that?
It was so great. And like, you're totally right. Like, it really makes you proud of yourself too.
Yes.
Just because you have to navigate, you have
yeah.
to figure out what you're doing. Like, there's no one there to be like, go here,
exactly.
you do this. Like, it's all you. And it just makes you really proud of yourself, makes
yes.
you really resourceful. It's
yes.
so great. It's so great.
I recommend it to anyone. I'm excited just to really like grow
yeah.
in like a new space.
Oh yeah.
Because like my family, my base, like my sister, this is her shop, like everyone's
yeah.
here.
Yeah.
Dallas is all
yeah.
I know.
And
so I'm just like,
you can't make that phone call, you can't be like, someone
exactly.
come get me, someone come whatever, like it's you.
Exactly.
Which is awesome. Because it kind of,
yeah.
it's going to be good. I
yeah.
highly suggest that to people when they're like,
yay.
Oh, it's just an internship where I'm like, do
take,
it.
Yeah, take it.
Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah. Good, how are
it's
you?
It's so good to see you.
Say, oh my God,
are you,
so
are you excited?
I'm so excited.
How stoked are you, scale 1 to 10?
So good.
No, shout out to her for real.
No.
Yeah.
Wow, no, this whole thing is, I'm just excited to see it come together on everyone else's like face and all of that. I love this because this matches the fabric.
Right? Okay.
Yes, it matches the fabric.
I was like,
very
wait,
well.
I have
yeah, no, this is good.
Okay, perfect.
No vacation. Your time coming, homie, stay patient. Be saying J, mama, call me Jason. Never was a hot in a good situation. People like me had to make a way and figure it out on my own. Pulling out on this loan. If you know, then you know. If you don't, then I hope one day we gon' make it out this drain. Chilling with the homies that be running up a joint. I don't even smoke, homie, that's just point. Let's look, I'm just trying to make my point. Come from where I'm from, you get tested. Damn, the funk is up, you don't mess with me. I swear this shit gon' get messy. I ain't even violent, I ain't even trying. Niggas get silent, sirens all I ever hear, cause we trying to make a living. I'ma tell you how I'm feeling, I'ma tell you where the riddance be at. Same old niggas talking wanna